This station, CFBX, we're on the TRU campus, and what we do is what's called alternative radio. It's an important part of our broadcast license, so we're not allowed to compete with any other radio station in town. And all of the programming that's done right here at CFBX is done by volunteers. No one here is a professional broadcaster. Some of us do have some professional training, but majority of the people who are here are volunteers from the community and from Thompson Rivers University. Very important part to get as many different voices on the air as possible and as many different ideas on the air as possible. We're a non-commercial radio station, which means that we'll play music and information that you can't hear on any other radio station, which is another very important part of what we do. So that's going to be ranging anywhere from heavy metal to hip-hop to classical and folk. Yeah, this room we're standing in is the CFBX library. It's the basement of the building the station is in. And there are about 35,000 individual albums here. And you'll notice just behind me is the CDs, and everything done here is, we are going to be moving into a more digital, we are going to need to go in a more digital direction in the coming years, but we also kind of pride ourselves as having the physical albums here and being able to pull it off the shelf and play it that way. It's an important part of what we do, how we differentiate ourselves from a commercial radio station. Record fair is going to be coming up on May 14th. That's Mother's Day at the Sally Center Mall, happening 10 till 4. Teamed up with Sally Center Mall, they're going to be doing some special events during that day, so we'll be part of that that day's events. We try and do this every year. It's a major fundraiser for the station, and we're hoping to raise a couple of thousand dollars for the station and our ongoing expenses. We'll have a lot of used vinyl, used CDs, used tapes. Tapes are starting to come back in a big way, as well as vinyl. Stereo equipment, musical instruments, all sorts of stuff like that. And it's not just us going to be selling it. We have over 45 tables already sold from vendors around the area are going to be coming in and selling their work. This is the on-air booth. It's where all the magic happens for our radio station. And all of the live radio is done here. It's another reason why we exist. Might surprise you to know that a lot of commercial radio isn't done live, but our radio station is done live as much as possible. So board in front of me is the on-air board, what we use to broadcast everything out over the air, and the equipment in front of me is CD players are here, turntables are underneath this here, and all basically everything you need is written in front of you here, and it's all done live. Well, the next step I think for us is going to be relocating our transmitter, because it's strapped to the side of this building. It's all line of sight, so the drumlin behind us kind of blocks things, and the building that's over here kind of blocks things. So I think in the future we're probably going to be fundraising to move the antenna to higher ground. We're not exactly sure where that's going to be yet, but we figure it'll cost us between about $15,000 to $20,000 at least, and that's something we'll be having to fundraise for in the next few years. And if anyone's interested in getting cables of their own, then get the entry forms at our website at thex.ca, thex.ca.